stories. Since he is not with us,
hi, Al, it's Aaron. I'm now at the board meeting.
Hi, Aaron. How are you?
You can say hi to all of the...
There's no one speaker. Okay. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Okay. Regarding the stipulation of settlement in paragraph 4, there is talk about the East Ramapo...
Before you continue, does he know that we're in the open session?
You know, we're just to let you know, we're in open session.
Well, if it's a legal advice, you probably can go into executive session if you
want to
do that.
Well, it was the issue that was raised by Star, and I know there was a response. It was a response from you.
Yes.
Do you want to speak to that concern?
Sure.
Should we go into
the agreed figure is less than the certified rate. There was a stipulation that was signed last June, which related to there was something like a $2.3 million settlement that had to be paid within 10 days on that. And the penalty provision provided that if it wasn't paid within 10 days, then the district was going to have to pay the certified rate. The certified rate is always certified by the state in arrears. In other words, after the expenditure is on. So in effect, there is a discounted rate that the district is getting from Kiryas Joel, and I understand that was the arrangement for a number of years. That's exactly the same mechanism that's being utilized in this settlement with respect to the three children and there were some summer charges as well, I think, on the chart. So it's no different than that which was already done by the district last June. And if it doesn't make any sense to me to delay a payment only so you can pay more, because then in terms of the issue of reimbursement, Starblood wasn't exactly clear. I got it later in the day, so I didn't have an opportunity to speak with her. Is she at the meeting?
She's also at the meeting.
Okay. Is she saying that there is no reimbursement if it stays in advance? Because that makes no sense to me at all.
Is she saying
she didn't hear what you were saying.
Can you hear me, Star?
Yes, I can.
Yes, you can.
I believe it was in the second paragraph of your letter. Are you saying that if we don't pay the certified rate, we're not entitled to any reimbursement whatsoever?
No, what I'm saying is that if the rate never gets certified, then we lose the opportunity to get reimbursed by the state. And that has been, we've had to...
Can you come a little closer to the phone to know this area of work?
Yeah, she's coming closer.
My understanding is that in the past with Kiryas Joel, we've had to ask them repeatedly to do their filings. And if they don't do their filings, then we lose the opportunity to collect our state aid. So what we were trying to do is to, in order to force them, in essence, to do their filings, which their payment would only be delayed by 60 to 90 days, once they do their get their rate certified, then we would be able to collect our aid and they would get their payment. It only seems fair. Other than that, there's no recourse for us.
If I'm understanding what you're saying, the certified rate is a higher rate than what they're required.
Well, if it's not, if there's no dollar amount that's certified, then we get the opportunity to collect no aid.
Well, ultimately, there is going to be an amount that is certified because that's how they arrived at the, what was it, $60,000 a child, was it?
Yes, but like I said, we've had to, in the past, we've had to ask them repeatedly to do their filings, and it's only in this past year that we were able to get them to do several filings. That's why we came to the conclusion of making those payments. We finally got them to do their filings so that the rates got
certified. But those payments were not made on the basis, the filings, the certified rate, as I understand it, isn't certified by the state until perhaps 8 or 10 months or more after the money is due and paid.
No, my understanding is that the certification would come 60 to 90 days after, and the only reason why it's taken that long for the rates to be certified is because the paperwork has been delayed getting to the state from the school providing the service, Kiryas Joel.
Okay, so what you are saying is that there should be a provision added that Kiryas Joel agrees to submit the paperwork to the state in an expeditious fashion in order to facilitate the reimbursement process to us.
Absolutely, or some kind of provision that gives us some kind of recourse if they fail to get the rate certified.
Okay, I'm going to try to reach their attorney right now, and is there a number there that I can call you right back at?
Yeah, you can go.
You're going to be with you when I get a 10, because I have his cell phone number on my computer.
You can call me back on my cell phone.
Okay, I'll call you right back. Bye-bye.
Notwithstanding the issue that the attorney is going to discuss with the attorney of Kiryas Joel, is there any other discussions other than these items that anybody would like to discuss?
Mr. D'Agostino, in his email today, responding to Star, referenced the MOU last year. Has that been paid? That's all settled?
Oh, yes.
Okay, that's done.
Mm-hmm. The only outstanding amounts are the amounts that appear within the stipulation.
And what's the total?
The total right now is $607,304. Understand that almost $400,000 our current charges. We would typically be paying May, and they just sent us June. We don't have a problem expediting.
Is this for 11 students, right? I mean, it doesn't say in there, but I think if I pulled out the actual appeal, I thought it was for, the original appeal was for 13 students, and then two of them.
Well, this total for 607 includes our regular students and our family home students as well. It's not just the original students that were in question. They've included all of our payments together.
Okay, and then it also agrees for the current school year 2010-2011.
There's no payments here for 2000.
Yeah, but I think it agrees.
Yeah, the settlement is a negotiation.
In other words, we agree to pay
back and then
here,
going forward.
And we also
agree
going forward for the current year at the same rate.
At a reduced rate.
It's a reduced rate.
We reduced it, I believe, by $5,000.
I didn't know that.
If you look at paragraph 4.
So the $58,500 is less than what we were.
We were paying.
Well, wait a second.